Hey, so I've been trying to break down a couple Garry Tonon kneebars from this week, one that happened at the 1FC, and I've gotten a lot of copyright things, so I've had to kind of mess with the size of the screen here. So, these attacks are going to be when somebody is coming around to the back. I want to pay attention to what Garry is doing on the leg he's not attacking. Right, so you see Gazanov here. I think he ducks under or spins around to the back. And then I don't know if you can see Garry's legs with how this screen capture is, but his right leg is in between the legs. He rolls through here to attack this left leg knee bar, but r the real important thing to pay attention to is this scoop Garry has on the other leg. He's not attacking this leg, but he's scooping it and rolling in such a way where he's laying on top of it. This is going to make it very difficult for Gazanov to build up any kind of base or spin or rotate out. Gary's weight's on the leg, and Gary's still using his right hand to trap that foot, right? He's going lat knee bar. I think he's going to go from a triangle. He's going to like press off of his own foot for extra leverage. He's going to go foot to foot here in a second. The volume's not on here, obviously, but there's a really loud crack and a really loud screaming verbal tap. But you can hear that, or you can see that this right arm stays kind of around this Achilles the whole time, even though this is the leg being attacked. And you may think that a triangle is like the strongest way to finish these knee bars. It's a secure way to hold the leg, but this foot-to-foot position really is killer as far as leverage goes. And I just want to show that even though a lot of Garry Tonon stuff, a lot of people miswrite it off as kind of being like scrambly and improvised, but it's really, these are attacks that he does a lot. So going back to ADCC 2019 semifinals against JT Torres, JT's up by two in overtime. He's coming around to the back, right? You're going to see the same attack on the same leg. So here you can even see Garry is starting to hook the leg that he's not going to knee bar before the roll even happens. So he's got it hooked. He's going to roll over the shoulders. Boom. And then right here you can see he keeps that bicep grip, crook of the elbow, like a rear naked choke around that Achilles. And the weight here, you can really see how on top of the knee he is, and it just makes it so difficult. JT can't run interference with this foot to protect this leg, and rotating out of this is just also a lot more difficult with the other person's weight on top. So there's only 4 seconds left in the match. Garry bridges in, doesn't quite get the finish. JT went on to win that year. Garry got bronze. And then if you look here in Polaris against Gilbert Burns, excellent grappler in the UFC, ADCC medalist. This one's not a knee bar, but again, Gilbert's coming up behind Garry. I think some of the legs are cut off here, but this is kind of the cue that leg steps behind. Gary's going to roll this time. Instead of getting the free leg, Garry reaches that hand to the lat. And this kind of secures them in place and helps give some position, some base. When you roll, it's that same scoop grip on the leg. But here, Gary's going to go to the cross ashi or the saddle position, 411. There's a million names for it. He's going to find the shoelace cross ashi. Right? So the shoelaces are against the butt here. And this makes it very difficult for whoever's in the heel hook to do a turnout escape, even without control over the secondary leg. And it adds a ton of increased hip contact to the side of the leg. So that you see the toes and the armpit for the inside heel hook, and super powerful finish that gets it done. So think about when you do those Victor rolls, trapping the leg that you don't want to attack with your arm, with any sort of a scoop grip.